plan, that's what they call me. I promise that you'll never be lonely.
Welcome back to another video on OzHDS. Today we're gonna be, or I'm gonna be showing you how to turn your standard Nerf modulus into a sniper, and then we're gonna test it out to see how good it actually is. So you have your Nerf modulus. First step, you're gonna take the stock. You should have this if you have the Nerf modulus. Just gonna pop the clip right on, so it should look like this. Pretty simple. This is a barrel extender that did come with the Nerf modulus, so it should just fit right on the edge, just like so. Your gun should look like this. After you do that, you are going to take another barrel extender. This came with a, I don't know what you call it, like the sniper attachment kit. So if you have that, just throw it right on the end. So it should look like this. Next, you're gonna take this scope, which came with this barrel extender. So these two came in the same kit, so if you have this one, you should have this one. So just slide that one right back on the top. Oh my god, this is quite the gun here. It should look like this right now. It looks like a sniper, but we have three more things. Bipod. Again, this came with the scope and the barrel extender and the sniper kit. So yeah, toss this on wherever you want. You can put it here or you can put it here. I'm gonna put it down up here. I'm gonna put it up here, the very top. So your gun should look like this. Next, you have the banana mag. This came with the Nerf modulus. You can use whatever magazine you want. Typically, I use this one just because I get to hold my gun by the mag, and since it's a banana mag, it gives me a nice curve. Last thing, this one is optional. You can take an extra magazine and throw it in the stock just like this. It'll fit just like that. So the final result should look like this. It looks pretty cool. And yeah, let's go into testing it. Everyone, so we have the range set up. So I'm gonna be aiming for this water bottle, or Gatorade bottle, that's over here. And I'm gonna be shooting from back here. There's the gun. So yeah, let's dive right into it. So there's the bottle, and let's run over to the gun and start shooting away. Alright guys, so we're just gonna go do that again and see what other results we can get. So yeah, let's try again.
This is the second round, so yeah, let's go over and start shooting again. And we've got a jam on the first shot.
shooting back up. It was a pretty good shot.
Everyone, so that was the second round, and let's
see you guys back in the room.
All right, guys, so overall it was pretty decent. As you guys saw, some of the shots were really accurate and some of the other ones weren't so accurate and quite off the mark. As like at the end of round two, you saw me missing a lot of shots, so this gun does kind of jam quite a bit. We have like 5 or 6 jams, so gotta make sure you pull that trigger pretty hard and quick, and make sure the motors are, you want to make sure are going before you shoot. So one problem is if you're gonna, you know, snipe, like you go at far distance and snipe in a Nerf war, I would, you know, check the jam hole every time you shot, because you don't want to make a bunch of loud noise like this and then miss your shot or have it jammed, which would cause them to give away your location and then you're dead because your gun is jammed and it takes like 10 seconds to unjam it. So do I recommend this in an Air 4? I would say yes. If you're gonna run around and, you know, play mid range, no. Close range, no. Only far range, and make sure people can't hear the loud motor. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys next time in another video. Make sure you leave a like and subscribe. I'll see you guys later.